Good morning, Lincoln Lions. Today is Tuesday, October 11th. Happy Tuesday. Today, you have a special snack that teachers will pick up or send students to pick up this morning at about 9. That is a special fruit. So every Tuesday and Thursday, you guys get a fruit or a vegetable that you get to have as a snack, and it's a little something that you get to try that might be new. And so one thing we're going to start doing is I'm going to show what that snack is on the KROR on Tuesdays and Thursdays, tell you a little bit about it, and try it with you. So exciting. Sometimes it can be scary to try new things, but if we all try it together, it's not so bad. So our special fruit for today is a honeydew melon, and you can kind of see it's a light green color. And let's see, here's a little info about the honeydew melon. The sweet, juicy flesh of a honeydew melon is one of summer's supreme pleasures. Here's what you need to know about this luscious fruit. Oh, all the vocabulary, including where it came from and how to choose it, and the novel deal that Alexandra Dumas rigged to get a lifetime supply. Oh my goodness. So, honeydew history. Honeydew is the American name for the white Antibes, a variety of melon that was cultivated in the southern France and Algeria, in southern France and Algeria centuries ago. So this is a fruit that originally comes from the south of France. Honeydew and other melons are part of the gourd family, which is divided into fruits, which are melons, and vegetables, squashes, pumpkins, and cucumbers. All right, the honeydew capital of the world, Cavillon, a town in Provence, France, considers itself the world capital of melons. Novelist Alexandre Dumas reportedly asked for a dozen melons per year until his death in exchange for donating his works to the town's public library. What an interesting fact. So let's have a taste and let's see. Have you ever had honeydew melon before? I have to tell you, I have. It's one of my favorites. So, a little bit crunchy, definitely nice and melony tasting. It makes me think of summer. I can't wait to hear what you all think of honeydew melon. All right, our Mr. Brown's precept for today, going along with, again, our character trait for responsibility, is this. Don't depend on other people to be responsible for you. A great reminder that we alone are responsible for ourselves. That's meaning we're responsible for our actions, what we do, how we treat others, all of that. So one more reminder again, we are really working to look and see what's happening out at the playground and try to problem solve. And we've got some ideas. A huge thank you to our playground teachers, Mr. OK Carr and Mrs. Sowers, for being out there to kind of help problem solve. Here is one of the things we noticed yesterday. There are the organized games, right? We have Fastest Tiger in the West that's in the field. We have the other games that have the little sandwich boards with the directions. We are not starting different games, right? It's really important that the games that we are playing out there are games that we all have learned the rules from. And thank you to Mr. Charette for teaching those in PE. So those are a huge thing that we need to make sure we're keeping in mind, that we are not starting other games like flag football on the blacktop. That's not something we're gonna do. So Fastest Tiger in the West is there. We are also, teachers will send a communication once we get all of our ideas put together. But for fourth and fifth grade, we're gonna have one basketball court playing the rules of the Lincoln basketball that will be for fourth graders, and one court that will be for fifth graders. As always, don't forget, I loved that I saw so many kids rocking it out on the playground yesterday when they were playing Fastest Tiger in the West. Awesome job. So, few reminders about that, making sure that we're being safe and responsible and respectful out on the playground. Also, our playground teachers, it's so important that you are listening and following their directions. They are the teachers of the playground. It's important that you're respectful and follow what they're asking you to do. All right, let's stand for the flag salute. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I hope you all have a wonderful day of learning. I am so glad you're here. Make good choices.